COVID-19 cases more than doubling this week at UMass Amherst. It follows an off-campus tailgate party from last weekend where students were shoulder to shoulder. Western Mass News reporter Leon Purvis has more.
Cases at UMass last week were 149. Positive cases for this week are 371.
I think it was expected, if anything. There's really no way you can bring 20,000 plus people on, like, into a pretty compact space without expecting that.
It's definitely alarming because, like, I do see, like, a lot of just, like, violations of, like, the guidelines and stuff.
Mixed reaction from UMass students on cases being more than double this week compared to last week. Let's break down the numbers for you. For September 1st to the 7th, the total number of cases were 149. Digging deeper, 19 were from on-campus students. 127 of those cases were from off-campus students. 3 from faculty and staff, with an almost 4% positivity rate and more than 3,800 tests performed. This week, there is a total of 371 cases, 68 of them on-campus students, 292 off-campus, 11 of them from faculty and staff, but the total tests performed are more than 8,000, with a positivity rate of just above 4%. In response to the rising cases, the university released this statement. The university will begin adaptive testing to identify students who may be at risk of infection. Selective students, for instance, in particular residential areas or social groups, will be asked to come in for additional testing so public health officials can better understand the transmission of the virus in our community. So we asked students what they thought of that.
That's fine. I mean, they can ask. Can they force people to do it? I don't know. I think we'll find out. We'll see.
Yeah, I think that's a good thing. Just really stratifying, like, the population and just, like, doing one group.
As of now, the on-campus parking and tailgating event is still on for Saturday. The hope is everyone will be able to enjoy UMass football while staying socially distant. In Amherst, Leon Purvis, Western Mass News.